So hi y'all, welcome to my channel, and today we're going to be doing a video which is the most requested video on my page. And if you've been on this channel for quite some time, I think you pretty much know what I'm going to be talking about, which is going to be my top 7 eyeshadow palettes under $7.99. So let's start off. So let's quickly start off, and at place number 7, we have the Stay Quirky Sexy Eyes Eyeshadow Palette. And I had two of these and I gave one away to my friend, and this is the one which I have right now. I think that these eyeshadow palettes have a good range of colors, like they have an equal balance between the mattes and the shimmers. And coming to the formulation wise of it, the mattes in this are simply amazing. They don't feel chalky, you know, they basically like, they have a lot of pigment in it, and they also feel very buttery at the same time. These aren't difficult to use like a pro pigment palette, but at the same time, they're very buttery and they feel very, very, very easy to blend. So another thing which I wanted to mention about this palette is that the shimmers in this aren't very, very, very strongly sparkly. You know, they're basically like your basic normal shimmers, like they have a sheen and they have some shimmers which is running through it, and they have a base along with it. It looks more of a pearly to a shimmery shade. There's nothing too extreme about the shimmers, which I'm very happy about. So I would say that get this if you're looking for very good quality matte eyeshadows. They're very pigmented. They also blend beautifully. I think this is a good buy for it. So moving on to position number 6, we have the Swiss Beauty Eyeshadow Palettes, and these are the £9 ones. And I honestly will say that I love the formulation of the mattes in these eyeshadow palettes. These are really good. The previous one, the pigmentation is like a little better than these, but these blend out a lot better than the Stay Quirky ones. So that's the reason why this is one step higher than the previous one. But when you look at the shimmers in this palette, I would say that the shimmers are not great. I in fact don't like the shimmers at all. It just feels waxy without much color. You know, it doesn't have color. It just feels waxy, and you don't get any intensity, you don't get any pigmentation, nothing out of the shimmers in this. But this palette has majoritively mattes, and I think this is perfect for like college, office. You know, you just want a couple of like warm neutrals. I think this would be perfect for it. I'm going to leave the swatches over here for you to check it out, but get the Swiss Beauty palettes if you're looking for good quality mattes, but do not rely on the shimmers in this palette. So moving on to the next one is the Mars I Belong In Your Purse eyeshadow palette, and this one is in the shade Oozing Swagger. So this one is again a £9 palette, and I like this one a lot. And the reason why is because the mattes in this are absolutely phenomenal. They're very buttery, they're very soft, and they blend really well. And I would say the shade range in this is simply amazing. So when you compare this to the Swiss Beauty one, I feel like the Swiss Beauty certain shades are duds, you know, like they have two shades which look very similar on the eye, but that did not happen with this palette. And also the same with the Stay Quirky palette, that did not happen with this. Like when you see the mattes and you see the shimmers, there is a good range of colors, and there's always a good difference between each and every single color in this. I absolutely love that one for this reason. This is more of a berry to pink toned palette. If you're looking for something like that, I think this is a great option for it. Okay, so moving to the shimmers in this palette, there is something about the shimmers in this which I do not like a lot. Like, I mean, I'm okay with it, but I don't have a big thing about it. The first thing is that they're very, very, very waxy to touch, and they kind of come like a cream in your hand, and you can kind of apply it or put it on your eyes or anything. And you will also notice that it starts to crumble a little bit when you're applying it. So there's a bit of this, you know, this, it's just a weird formulation with a lot of drugstore palettes. I think it's something that they do to, you know, like with the cost factor of it. I don't like that when it comes to, the drugstore eyeshadow palettes. But when you see the finish of it, I think these are beautiful. They have a very high shine finish. So, the finish wise, I like it a lot, but I don't like the formulation, and I don't like how it feels when you apply it and how difficult it is to work with it sometimes. So that is a bit of a bummer. That's why I've put this a little lower in the, you know, the ranking place. But nevertheless, this is a great palette for the cost as well as the good color range which you're getting, and the mattes in this are phenomenal. So moving on to place number 4 is the Nikake eyeshadow palettes, and I have two of them and I like this one a little more than the other one only because of the color story, but the formulation remains pretty consistent. Now, speaking about the mattes in this eyeshadow palette, the mattes in this palette are absolutely amazing. They blend beautifully, they're very pigmented, they do not get matty, they do not get patchy, and you know, I just love the formulation when it comes to the mattes in this. These look phenomenally well, and also the color story in this palette has been like very nicely put out, which I like. Now moving on to the shimmers in this palette. Now the shimmers in this palette are again very similar to the Mars one, and they have that movement in them, like that waxy texture which I'm telling you. The waxiness in this makes it crease a lot, which is something I don't like, but if you have a very smooth eyelid, I think it should work really well. And it kind of separates when you're applying it, doesn't give you an even application, which is also something I do not like about the shimmers in these palettes. But nevertheless, for the price point and for the finish of it, I think it's really good. Only the application part of it is a little tricky when it comes to these palettes. So moving on to position number 3, we have the Pigment Play eyeshadow palettes, and I think these are the most expensive ones in the entire line. And coming to the formulation of these, the mattes in this are simply amazing. These are extremely buttery, they're very well pigmented, and they layer beautifully. You can blend multiple different colors and get a beautiful gradient. I think these mattes in this are amazing. For me, when it comes to an eyeshadow palette, if the mattes in this are doing really good, I'm pretty much happy with it, because I can do a look with just mattes, but I can't do a look with just shimmers. So I always side up to mattes, and if, you know, suppose it's an eyeshadow palette, if it has good mattes, it kind of crosses my, you know, like my evaluation parameters. So when you speak about these, I think the mattes in this are simply amazing. And moving on to the shimmer formulations of these palettes. So the shimmers in these, they do not crumble. They do not have a waxy texture as much as the Nikake or the Mars one. They are also slightly waxy, but not as much as those. And these do not skip when you're applying, which is something I like. You get an even shimmer application with these, you know, so I like them for that reason. Even the darker colors, you know, they just work really well, the shimmers in this. I like it for that reason. You get a very even application of product. They have a decent amount of metallicness with it. The formulation is easy to work with. They're pretty high shine. So I like these palettes over the Nikake one and the Mars ones for that reason when it comes to shimmers too. So I would definitely say that try out the Pigment Play palettes if you're looking for something which is really good in the drugstore range. So another thing which I noticed about the Pigment Play eyeshadow palettes is that there's barely any fallout when you're using it, which is something I like. And I think that these work really good with a brush too, so you don't have to really rely on your fingers for shimmer application. So moving on to place number 2, we have the Nykaa Eyes On Me eyeshadow palette, and I have this one in the shade Beachside Peach. And I think I do have a look with this on my feed. You can always check it out. And this one is predominantly, you know, a peach brown toned palette, like a lot of warm tones in it. I think this is perfect if you are looking for something in that color family. They do have a couple of options. They have one for smoky eyes. They have one which is a little more berry toned. I wanted to try the smoky eye ones, but I have so many palettes which look pretty much smoky, so I didn't, and I wanted to get the peach one for that reason. The shimmer formulation in this is amazing. This one is not waxy at all like the other ones. They feel like your regular metallic shimmers. They do not crumble, they do not flake, and they're also very high shine. So I like them for that reason. And coming to the mattes in this, Nykaa did an amazing job with the matte eyeshadows as well as the shimmer eyeshadow. So formulation wise, I think they did a great job with this palette compared to their previous one. There was another one which they released which has more number of pans. I think it was a 16 pan one. So compared to that one, this one is amazing. They killed it when it comes to the formulation. I love the formulation of this palette. And I think the color range is also pretty good. It starts with a really light set of mattes and has a really good set of deeper tones. They have a good amount of shimmer variations also. So I think overall, this palette is pretty cohesive with the color theme, and it also has a good balance of light to dark. So this would be great if you're looking for something in the color family. But I would definitely say that you can try out the other options, because literally everything in this is like a peachy color, you know, so you can try out another one. You don't need 10 shades of 10 variations of peach. So that is another thing about the palette. But coming to the packaging, I think the packaging is the worst I've ever tried in my life. This packaging is like really bad. Like if I drop it once, it's gonna shatter completely. So I do not like the packaging. It's not travel friendly. It's not friendly if you have butterfingers, you know, so this is not perfect for that. I think the rest of them, the packaging was pretty good, but I'm not too happy about this packaging. But formulation wise, this one is great. Okay, so last but not the least, we have place number one, which is the e.l.f. eyeshadow palettes. And these are the bite-sized eyeshadow palettes. And honestly, I don't know why it took me so long to try out these palettes. The one which I have is the Style Cream and Sugar. And I would say that this is just pretty amazing. This is like a perfect neutral travel palette. It's not too warm, it's not too cool, and I really love the color combinations in this, and the finish of the shimmers in this are simply outstanding. The shimmers feel like a lot of my other high-end eyeshadow palettes, if I might say so. But I mean, like, it has a beautiful high shine, and it doesn't crumble, it doesn't crease, it doesn't crack. It just goes on really smooth. It works really good even if you have texture on your lid. The matte, like this one and the other one, they're beautiful too. Like, they have an amazing pigmentation and you get really good amount of color on your lid. You can always like lighten this out and use it in your crease also, and I think this is just beautiful. They do have a couple of colors, you can always try them out, but formulation wise I think the matte as well as the shimmer, both of them are amazing in this. You do get the high shine finish with this without having that waxy mix which was involved in the palettes. I think this is a great one for your buck, and I would definitely recommend that you should try these ones out. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and do give me a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you did, and let me know which other palettes you want me to try, review, give you my opinion on, or if you want to see another high-end version of the same, my top 7 palettes or anything like that, you know, just let me know and I would be happy to do that for you. And just check out my other videos which are similar to these. I would link them down in the description bar below, and stay tuned for some more videos. Until next time, bye!